The little one will follow in my footsteps someday. Grandpa Hans is already convinced of this as he holds his granddaughter in his hands for the first time. 40 years later, it is obvious Grandpa Hans was right. And Maxie knows that Grandpa Hans likes to be right, especially when it concerns the business that he once started. Granddaughter Maxie, who runs the family business now, is very satisfied. As of recently, the family business can finally protect itself against payment risks in connection with open account commercial transactions. If necessary, they can sell their book receivables to their house bank to improve liquidity. To make this happen, the payment protection tool, Bank Payment Obligation, which has been introduced in July 2013, is used. However, Grandpa Hans is, as always, skeptical. It makes sense to him that UniCredit purchases outstanding account receivables, vis-a-vis domestic buyers of his company's products. However, Grandpa Hans remembers that in the case of foreign customers, payment protection and the without recourse sale of account receivables was, in the past, hardly possible without the use of letters of credit or credit insurance policies. This was also the case for the Fu Tang Company from China, one of the most important customers to whom the family business has sold its products for more than 50 years now. Indeed, Grandpa Hans has never doubted the payment practices of his customer and therefore always granted him a 90-day period to settle the invoices. Due to the political and economic uncertainties, he often had an uneasy feeling. But letters of credit were too expensive, too time-consuming and cumbersome due to the fact that the company issues dozens of invoices every month. However, his bank could not purchase the resulting account receivables from him without any bank security. For this reason, in the past, Grandpa Hans had to use his working capital credit facilities to bridge the liquidity gap until the invoices had finally been paid. What has suddenly changed today that the bank can now purchase the account receivables on a without recourse basis, wonders Grandpa Hans. Maxie explains to her grandpa. UniCredit can do this because they offer their clients a state-of-the-art internet-based platform for the without recourse purchase of account receivables. Maxie can upload the invoices directly from her ERP systems onto this automated purchasing platform. Grandpa Hans is confused. Too much technology overwhelms him quickly. Maxie tries using a simple example. His great-granddaughter Pia likes to share her photos online with her friends. To do this, she must upload the photos to an internet platform. Grandpa Hans is amazed. But does UniCredit have credit lines for the Fu Tang Company? Maxie knows they don't need to. UniCredit maintains close relationships with the house bank of the Fu Tang Company, one of its main correspondent banks. You see, Maxie asked the Fu Tang Company to instruct its bank to issue a bank payment obligation in favor of UniCredit. The advantage, with the bank payment obligation, the Chinese bank irrevocably undertakes to pay the invoice amount on the invoice's due date. This, in turn, serves UniCredit as security in order to purchase the account receivables against Fu Tang from the family business. Speaking of security, with the help of flexible currency hedges, the company can also secure itself against foreign exchange risks and offer its clients the option of issuing the invoices in the local currency of its customers. Therefore, in this case, renminbi. For Fu Tang, this is a huge advantage, and for Maxie, an additional strong selling point. Amazing, marvels Grandpa Hans. Thanks to the bank payment obligation, a company not only needs lesser credit lines, it finally can get protection against economic and political risks, which, in the past, the company had to bear itself. Well done, acknowledges Grandpa Hans. In his days, he was not so well served.